once again, welcome to today's presentation. Thank you for your subscription channel, and thank you so far so good for your comments. I've received a lot of fantastic comments from a subscriber and towards the last production, and I appreciate your contribution. I want to tell you that this channel is meant to educate you and also to furnish you with the necessary information on how you can design a free energy generator. We are out to combat high cost of energy bill and also to make the world a better place. Last production, we talked about something very important and very, very necessary on how you can produce a free energy generator with low cost, as how you can spend less in the process of producing free energy generator. Now make a lot of illustration using a lot of things to show you on how you can do this. I pointed out some vital area which I know many of you have called me and also to ask you questions. Today I'm going to also do a very important production on how to make free energy generator using local materials. The reason why this is necessary, because many people ask questions about high cost materials. Some say the generator is too cost, some say they have enough money to purchase a motor and others. And I feel necessary that I should. The essence for the channel is to educate you and also to make way for you to produce, because we want everybody to be part of this innovation. And that is why I have to bring this one, for you to be able to know how you can use local materials to produce the generator, how you can source for local materials around the environment, and how to put together and produce energy. I want to tell you, a free energy generator is very easy to produce. All you just need to do is to get the necessary materials and the requirements needed. Construction is done and you are yet to go. In today, you see something like this. Last time I discussed about this in the last version, and also mentioned about some vital area which you need. For instance, I mentioned about the motor. I told you specifically about the features of the motor, that the motor is the engine room of the generator. And if you want to produce any generator, you need a motor. And I also mentioned that the size of the motor also determine the output of generator, because the motor is the one that turns the generator, which is this. And I still remember that I told you about some of the things you need to know about the motor and the flywheel, because the flywheel, I told you earlier, that is a area that the kinetic energy is stored. And somebody asked a question, what do you mean by kinetic energy? And so kinetic energy is the temporary energy needed during the process of switching over from the external power source to internal power source, which is the generator, and also sometimes the batteries. So this is the area we have to explain, and we have explained in a very intensive way. Now today I have to go further to this area, which I know you will have interest. This is a very fantastic production with a local material generator. As you can see here, it's just a very simple generator to make. This flyway, you can source it, you can consult it using any metal closer to you. And then you use the bed, as you can see, the bed around the flyway. And then you can see, this is the generator. As you can see, it's not as fantasy as you can see, it's just something that's been sourced out within the locality. So with these few materials, the motor, the generator, you can be able to assemble this together and get a good generator for yourself. Let's take some look at this, and you see some of the things I'm talking about. Now, see this now. Okay, let's see this first. This is what I'm talking about now. You see, this is the generator, and this is the flywheel, and this is the motor. You see, this is, if you look at this apparent generator, you know, it is not just really fantastic. You see, you can see there is something sourced out from the local environment, and you can see how it is, but it also produces the required production you need. It does not really need so much alcohol, because you can see the papa who is doing the work, and he's just have not money to do it, but he had to just to put something together to help himself by cutting out the beer around. You can see now, this is the motor. And the motor produces one that does the engine room. But because the motor is also well equipped and well mounted, the output of the generator is also fantastic. As you can see, it in the process, you see, it's very fantastic because the motor is also good. And they might be hidden, see, you can see the sparking of the light to show that the generator is producing this maximum speed. Now, this is one of the things you need to know. If you observe here also, you see the ratio of the use. You're going to see the meter is running to the level which is to show the voltage indicator. Now we are on zero, but let us move the gas on motion and see how it moves to the next level. And see it's increase. It's increased now. Look at it, it's moving, still moving, still moving. To show you that the generator is on a speed. You can see this is moving now. See, so when the generator is plugged, you see that the material which is producing the full energy required for any work to be done. It's just a common generator. See how common it is. See how local it is. It's really fantastic. Also does the function that you need in producing light. Require voltage, you can install the booster. The booster enables the generator to boost the voltage from a bipolar level to another level. So this is very important in some area where you cannot have access to a very good battery generator. You can construct any one you have at a, and then buy the booster and use it to boost the voltage to the level you want. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because this is the very same. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because we know this is the same.